Hi there, and welcome to Go Rocky. So instead of buying a sound bar for my TV, I decided to go with a left and right speaker instead. So let's get to it.
Go Rocky.
So this is the SMSL AD18. By the way, this is still a 2.1. You can connect. It has a subwoofer out, a sub out for if you still need a subwoofer. But the good thing about this is that you can change up your left and right speakers. You'll see there the Foshan Shuang Wanlin Technology Company Limited. It's quite a mouthful, so I guess that's why they just put their SMSL. This is a 80 watts, two 80 watt speaker setup at 4 ohms, Bluetooth 4.2 with NFC, and it uses a Texas Instruments, I think, TAS-558C for digital signal processing. But I found that it's better turned off for my ears. I'd like to hear everything flat on the EQ. So now we got the manual, GOR codes for the link, USB 2.0 cord for your computer, and of course the power brick, the 24 volt power brick. I'd like to say that the power brick is just about the size of the actual unit itself. And there's a power cord. I apologize if you hear any grinders or any metalwork in the background. There's quite a bit of construction, and there's the unit. The power supply is actually almost the size of the power supply. And there's the NFC on the top part. As you can see, there's a protective film over the NFC. And that's the Bluetooth antenna, banana plugs, and Y connectors. This functions as a sub out and an optical in. If you want a sub out, you're gonna have to sacrifice one of the optical in features, auxiliary, USB, optical in one, and of course the power. There, it's almost the size of the power brick. There's a screen there. It's kind of a small screen. I guess it's OLED. Electroluminescent display. There's a clicking on the volume knob, and when you push it in to select some features, some adjustments. Everything is anodized aluminum. Very nice construction. 3.5 millimeter headphone jack there, and the IR port, the IR sensor. The remote is a simple remote. Some functions here, like I think the bottom alphabet buttons don't really function. Quite sturdy. The clicking feel on the remote, the click feel on the remote is quite okay. And we're just gonna put the batteries in here. By the way, the batteries I think did not come with the box. I had to use a TCL battery from my TV, my TCL TV. And it's about 3 inches tall. You'll see this is very compact. You can put it anywhere. This would even look perfect on probably a kitchen setup. It's about 2 inches on top. And it's about, is it 6.5? It's about 6.5. Yeah, it's about 6.5 long on the depth side. And I'll just screw in the Bluetooth 4.2 antenna. And I thought the antenna would actually spin to make it centered, but it goes with the thread. So I ended up not really tightening it up just for it to be centered. And there you have it. Very nice construction. Pretty solid. Also has rubber feet. Oh, that's me trying to peel off the film, but tried to stop myself from doing so. There's no film on the display, by the way. Just a serial number to control the QC. This is the remote for the Xiaomi, or the remote for my TCL TV. I have a 32-inch TV in the kitchen, so I'm just comparing the sizes. This is from a Xiaomi Mi Box S. And of course, the remote for the AD18. So this format of remotes is actually pretty universal. They probably share a mold and some small design alterations are present, but it looks to be a popular format for a lot of IoTs. And there you have it. Just the same size as the other remotes I have. Now we're just going to plug in the power cord here. I should have put this on fast forward, but that's okay. Now we'll just put in the power there. And again, by the way, the jack on the sub out shares a jack with the optical one optical in. So you're going to have to choose if you want a sub or if you have a secondary audio optical input. You would have to give up one of those. This is the Audio Quest medical grade optical cable that I'll be using to run from my TV to the AD18. Quite expensive at 2,800 pesos. And there's the guys at Plaza Fair. I forgot the name of the seller, but they sure took away the excitement from me for assembling the terminators for the speaker cables there. But that's okay. I guess they knew what they were doing and they had a better technique. So here I am taking home my cables. It's an ice cable, 14 gauge. Of course, the banana plugs are 4 millimeters. I bought about, I guess it's about 2.5 or 3 meters length per speaker. And I also bought this silicone tape because I wanted the end of the cable sleeve to somehow be a lot neater. Be more neat. So there's the silicone tape that I got from Lazada. I think it's about 80 pesos. This thing actually fuses by to itself when you wrap it around. You can also use this if you want to, if you have bare wires. It's actually watertight. I use this on one of my motorcycles, so I can make it watertight. But for today, I'm just gonna use it to make my cable ends look a bit neat. And for the rest of the cables there. Now for the right. And there you go. A little bit of cleanup there. And we move on to the Q Acoustics 3020i. It's a two-way reflex enclosure. I got this one as a display unit, discounted price about 17,000 or 16,550. Frequency response is about 64 hertz to 30,000 hertz. Can go up to 75 watts. Just the right amount for the AD18. Unfortunately, I did not find any handling gloves. That was reported on the website that's supposed to be in the box. Little film there for the Q logo. By the way, the woofer is about 5 inches in diameter, and the tweeter is about 1 inch, silk dome tweeter. So the rubber feet there, there's also a lock, by the way, if you want to put it on a speaker stand. Rubber feet doesn't really come off. I think it's friction mounted in there. Try to screw it off, but I can't. There is also an included silicone gel there, just in case you want to put some QP on it, snack, as a afternoon snack. The speaker grill is magnetic, has a little pad on the magnet so you won't scratch the vinyl. There is also an included foam bung for the rear port if you want to reduce the low frequency roll off, should I say, so it won't defeat the higher frequencies. Now, I'm going to install the speaker set against the wall without including these at the moment. So the binding posts there are 4 millimeters for banana plugs, and it's also it can also accept Y or U terminals. That was a really tight fit though. Was a good fit. Here I am thinking about putting the foam bungs in again. But later on, I am going to remove that. And we're just going to connect everything here, speakers, left and right. Pretty nice connectors from that shop in Plaza Fair. Power, that expensive AudioQuest medical grade optical SPDIF cable. And there, as you can see, the space on the wall is quite limited. It's about just a hair 3 inches or 2.5. So later on, we're going to be listening to that. And let's go ahead and turn it on. SMSL version 2.1. The optical 2 is actually for the TV. Optical 1 is the spare. But you can, of course, you can use either. Auxiliary, analog, Bluetooth, coax, input for CD or what have you. USB for the computer. By the way, I haven't found any drivers for the computer. I guess it goes in directly and it doesn't need any drivers like a USB speaker. The volume knob has a significant feel to it. It's a very nice feel, a clicking feel. There's a Sigma Delta Beta setting also, like an automatic kind of DSP, and some presets here, jazz, rock, country, rap. But I found that turning off the EQ was better for me because I like everything flat. You can also change the color of the screen, not the screen, but the color of the main the main setting indicators to green, red, blue, or white. And of course the level of brightness. And in just a bit we're going to play a video from my YouTube channel. And of course due to copyright restrictions, I'm gonna play some royalty free music as well. So we can hear how the sound is coming off the AD18 paired with the 3020i Q Acoustics. I hope you like this video. Please like and subscribe and click the bell icon if you want to see more videos and get updated. Have a nice day.
Hi, welcome to Go Rocky. This time around, we're going to build a smaller computer, a small form factor computer for office tasks and minor video editing. Essentially, a small form factor PC will free up some space and give you more area to work with. Because it's still a general community quarantine here in Metro Manila, 96% of the build is contactless. Only one item was bought.